Good afternoon, everybody. We are Team Cubicus, and we sent out some video of an underwater vehicle that's an autonomous spacecraft to the third video of the two devices. Today, I'm going to introduce the project here, and our teammates will cover our mechanical design decisions, our vision tracking system, and our vehicle performance. With some of our development team, we set out to solve some of the issues that guide us based on the two devices. One of the main ones we identified was the difficulties of obtaining underwater footage. As you can see here, equipment for obtaining underwater footage is very bulky and not much expensive. Additionally, if you're using this type of equipment, it requires you to fully focus on operating your cameras and not in order to enjoy the dive view effects. So that is the main motivation that we set out to solve, which was to take underwater vehicle that intention to dive the ship. And we want to do this in two main ways. First, we want to get a start dive site over a tunnel. That's what we see. Some of people are explore the conditions before entering the water in order to maximize your diving time. And second, to capture stabilized video of a scuba diver while he's diving, that you can get this new perspective. Radios are essentially the aerial equivalent of what you saw out here, where the naval surface and action footage is very accessible by tracking and recording the user action performance. So without inspiration, we formulated several project goals. With diving dive sites, we want to get live video feed from the vehicle back to the surface over a tunnel. And that one can include a control such that while you're operating it, you can clearly explore the environment with the vehicle. Second, for tracking the video of the diver, we need to implement a diver tracking system, such as a vehicle can follow the diver, as well as enable stabilized video and sound motion, such that we can get a very clear shot and have useful footage. And the best way to actually tell about our project flow is to show it, as well as this one. We also need several quantitative goals. We want to weigh down to 120 feet for maximum reliable depth for scuba diving. We want to last at least 60 minutes on battery, but the average length of the dive, we want to keep it under 40 pounds so a single person can carry and manipulate the vehicle. So that, this is what happens when you take out that as to your dive for. You can see this vehicle is tracking that diver, he's holding a vision tag that the vehicle can lock onto, you follow it, and it's recording video of an as you move. So you know that that video is a little freaky, and that's because it's from a handheld GoPro in another diver's hand. So in many scenes, if you take a look at what the vehicle is seeing, you can see the vehicle is engrossed by the tracking the diver, keeping him centered in the frame, and recording the well-stabilized video, and following him as he moves. We're really excited that our vehicle works to this level, and we can bring this unique perspective to the drivers who haven't known what happened before. So with that, I'm going to pass back to Aiden, who's going to talk about intent for the moment.
We put a lot of innovation and thought into the mechanical design of our vehicle. I'd like to walk you through the assembly of Cubicus and turn out some of our major design considerations. Cubicus starts with a main pressure vessel. This is machined from a single tubular aluminum extrusion. It's a rectangular shape simplifies the integration of the single vertical section and also makes it easier and more efficient to pack electronics and components within the vehicle. We use O-ring shears to seal all of the openings on the vehicle, as it will provide a robust and reliable seal. The first component that's attached to the vehicle is a front camera that seals off the front of the vehicle. This also adds a GoPro and stabilized gimbal for taking front stabilized video. Looking at the back of the vehicle, we attach a rear electronic enclosure that incorporates a power switch, water-proof wheels to connect to the motors, an 8-pin pedal connector, so when we're operating the vehicle in tethered mode, we can plug the pedal in and operate the vehicle as a gas connector. And two battery connectors in the bottom that allow us to supply the vehicle with power as a battery. Inside the vehicle are two electronic racks. The center electronic rack houses low voltage electronics such as processors, and the rear electronic rack houses high voltage electronics such as motor controllers and voltage regulators. These two electronic racks are connected with a 40-pin ribbon cable so that they can communicate and supply power between the boards. Looking at the top of the vehicle, a single pole is machined through the pressure vessel. This pole allows us to integrate a vertical thruster. This vertical thruster is mounted within an aluminum tube and sealed in the top and bottom of the O-ring. Back at the front of the vehicle, we add two thrusters in the horizontal plane. These thrusters enable the vehicle to move in X and Y and allow us to position the vehicle in a good spot to get well sustained and stabilized video as a battery. Next, we add battery racks. These battery racks mount the batteries to the side of the vehicle and made out of laser cutter parts so that in testing we can modify the vehicle dynamics by repositioning the battery rack relative to the main part of the vehicle. Battery pads are then inserted into the battery rack. These pads are removable, so that when batteries run low, you can swap them out with new fresh batteries and be up and running again. Finally, a float is installed on the top of the vehicle. This float serves two purposes. It makes the vehicle slightly positively buoyant so that it's easy to move up and down within the water time, and also provides a throw up phase. In the event that the vehicle loses power, the vehicle will slowly float to the surface. We've analyzed all of our parts and power loads in transfer to ensure that they will withstand pressures beyond our maximum depth. On the screen is an example of a part that we simulated in transfer, our main pressure hydrant. And we took advantage of the symmetry of this type to reduce simulation time and simplify the dynamic conditions of the type. Now, I'm just going to talk about the other dynamic conditions.
Thank you.
So, Capture And this is due to our basic understanding of the Bible. As we reach the fold of the table, by the study of the most important things, we've actually been able to speak for such great things as talking to the Bible, outside of us, as we actually reach the table, after we've been given by the Bible. And we do not have a Bible today.
Slightly positively buoyant for safety and secret retrievers, which means it always requires a downward thrust of one of your motors, and the deeper you go, the more force that has to exert to keep it at that depth. If you think about a ballast where you have a little pocket of air that you could fill and empty for. Wasn't a big variance of buoyancy from 0 to 120 feet.
Enough. How do you think it'll perform in open water? Because I think you said you tested it in the quarry. Is that Dutch Springs?
Yeah.
How about open water where there might be underwater currents or even waves which may, which are going to change your relative depth? You think that it'll be, but if let's say there's a current and just water motion, especially on the East Coast, I've been in some really.
So if there's a current, it's sort of most likely that the diver will have to be in that current. So the risk of crossing the barrier of the vehicle will be able to be crossing the diver and part of the diver to be able to get it.
All right, first of all, I want one of these. So when you're ready to test it in Hawaii, you let me know. I got a bunch of questions, so I apologize in advance. Have you thought about adding like cargo space for safety devices like 5 minutes of air or GPS tracking or any of those things? You're way under your weight limit, it seems to me that would be a natural. Second thing is, I noticed, so the propellers are fixed, they don't move?
No,
they're fixed.
Yeah.
So I'm curious why you chose an external design instead of an internal design where you had like tubes, a single thruster inside, you could open valves, and you could have like 6 or 8 different, basically jets that would stir up less water, right? And also allow you to make faster adjustments. Did you consider that? And it'd be less noisy and all that other stuff. Right, you could do it with one thruster and a bunch of valves, right? So you could do it for cheaper. Because you're going to put it in the middle, have two go around. And also, so it tracks by visual. I wonder why you chose visual tracking, because of course, visibility, right, is the big issue. If it gets too far away, the water gets too cloudy, or something gets in between you guys, why don't you choose something like, LIDAR or something?
I'm going to go to the back of it, because the vehicle can put it on the back of it.
Not often, if that's what you get to work in this period of time. The thing is, just for filming, yes, but it's also, it's nice to have a car open, you know, a little Sherpa carrying stuff for you, you don't have to lie, right? So I would want that even in low visibility conditions. Right. There are a lot of other reasons I want the budget for filming me, so. Yeah.
I think we could all have the funds and future versions to include for 5 and 6 minutes. The full dress is.
You do put a cost on it though, it's all the other ones. What is the total material?
The
No, it does actually cost about $2,300 just for the material.
Just for material.
Okay.
That's fine.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure. So that's the design. Thank you.